After we have designed our system, we can implement it. In the implementation phase, what we do is basically taking care of realizing the design of the system that we just created and create an actual software system. There are four fundamental principles or pillars that can affect the way in which software is constructed. The first one is the reduction of complexity. This aims to build software that is easier to understand and use. The second pillar is the anticipation of diversity, which takes into account that software construction might change in various ways over time. That is, the software evolves, and in many cases, it evolves in unexpected ways, and therefore we have to be able to anticipate some of these changes. The third pillar is the structuring for validation, also called design for testability. And what this means is that we want to build software so that it is easily testable during the subsequent validation and verification activities. Finally, and this is especially true within specific organizations and or domains, it is important that the software conforms to a set of internal or external standards. And some examples of this might be, for example, for internal standards, coding standards within an organization, or naming standards within an organization. As for external standards, if, for example, you're developing some medical software, there are some regulations and some standards that you have to adhere to in order for your software to be valid in that domain.